party, party. Yes, we're going to a party, party.
I'm 13 years older than Aaron. But we were down picking raspberries.
You're old.
Down in the bottom land of our Carterville Road house, when his aunt, Uncle Gene, came roaring down the hill to say, June's had her baby and it's a boy. And we could hardly wait to gather up our raspberry packing stuff to go to the hospital right then to see him.
Yeah, I was
and then he was a pain in the neck thereafter.
How big was that?
10 something.
Yeah.
Yeah,
he
was yelling, Queech! Yeah, that's what my mom said. She went, oh, Queech!
So I just had to come today, because like I say, I'm probably the only person who knows the day he was born. And we've been friends ever since, right?
Yes, we have.
Yes, we have.
I'd always go to California and end up at her house and spent some nights there.
Yeah, we had a lot of good times. But he was quite a problem child. He was really. My younger brother, who would be still alive, who would remember maybe that day, probably not. But he was just enough older than Alan that Alan got into his stuff, and you know how that goes. Get out of my stuff!
He's a bully.
She size is 15.
So we remember him as a little boy. I just wanted to say hello and happy birthday.
Thank you for sharing that.
Thank you.
And that's not me.
Because we never call him that.
Roger was your uncle.
I don't even know if they did that because they called me Alan, and my grandpa on mom's side is Alan, but he spells his with an E and an A. So I'm unique.
And you know what? My mom and dad, his family, the Miller family and the Lloyd family, we live next door. So my brother married his mother, who was the girl next door. And so those kids used to run back and forth. Remember, Colleen remembers running back and forth from one grandma to the other. And he'd get out of my house and he'd go, I have to call my mother.
Are you making fun of me?
I am.
But on the bus, on the ride home from kindergarten, on the bus, I stuck my head out of the window of the bus. I didn't know you weren't supposed to stick your head out of the window. Always did it in my car. And the bus driver slammed on the brakes, pulled me off the bus, took me around to the front of the bus, started chewing me up. He says, what's your name? And I said, Rar-Rar Mimu. He said, here, write it.
I don't know how to spell my word.
I'd never even
seen it. You never were called that.
I was never. And why would you call your kid a first name that you're not going to call him?
Good question.
It was it was a hassle all my life. Because then I'd show up at the hotels because I was on the road so much during the kids' years growing up that I'd go to the hotel to check in, I'd throw down my credit card, and they'd go, Roger Miller, huh? Sing us a song. I could bet that they were gonna say that, and almost everybody did, so.
Because he was a famous singer at the time.
Yeah, you guys might not know who he is.
We do.
Some of us, yeah.
But then when Colleen came along, she didn't even get the privilege of having to meet the name.
No. I didn't.
So she's just Colleen, yeah.
It's never too late. We could give you one right now.
Well, you know what? They do call me. They call me Myrtle.
Myrtle. Is that from Christy? Christy.
My kids or my friend, Scott does. We can be at a store. And he's a little far away from me.
I could be hollering, Colleen. She'll just keep on going. I say, Myrtle. Dead stop, turn around.
Well, I remember a certain cousin of mine who referred to her mother as Mildred.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. She answered me.
And that's because
there was ice cream and cake over here.
No. Thank you, Mr. Okay.
So, that.
Oopa!
Scott, are you gonna like add a little degree of difficulty or? Quit tomahawking it. Somebody needs to drink their protein shake.